But if you have an inaccurate belief that says your worthiness, your safety, your security comes from being right, from never being wrong, you're 100% trapped. In this episode of the Unstoppable Woman podcast, we are going to be discussing how you open to more. In particular, how you open to more cash flow, more revenue, more profitability, more money in your life and your business. Yes, there's lots of other good stuff out there. More love, more pleasure, more delight, more exhilaration, more calm, more peace, more freedom, more agency. All of that counts today, because many of you are in business for yourself and many of you are interested in being free from the constraints of not having enough money, whether you're in business for yourself or you work in a company. You must learn how to create cash flow, how to really be the master of money, not the slave of it. Money is such a key resource in our life. It's used to exchange value. What you find is valuable. The things that you desire to purchase, those are the things that you find valuable. Now, sometimes you might think you need to purchase something because you're trying to fill a void in your heart. That's not what we're talking about. But the things that you truly desire that come from a place of like, yeah, I really do want that. You know, that is might scare you to want it, might seem in some ways wrong to want something because of a belief structure that says, oh, that's frivolous or that's too much or only greedy people or people who don't care about the environment or people who are spendthrifts or people who whatever, fill in the blank, whatever your money story is. Only people like that, the other, the bad, purchase these things. And it can be very subtle. Like, it can be around like a pair of shoes. Like, only people who are frivolous buy expensive shoes. Well, what if you just bought one pair of expensive shoes, wasn't frivolous, or that pair of shoes helped you grow your business? In fact, I have a story about this that one of my clients recently shared with me, or reminded me of. We met at a conference, and I was wearing this beautiful DVF dress that stands for Diane Van Furstenberg. She's a fabulous designer. Love her stuff. And I was wearing this fabulous DVF dress, and I felt like $1 million, and I was communicating that to the world and to this woman that I was speaking to. And she was drawn to me because of this dress, and then was drawn even further into my world because of how I spoke about business and what I addressed when she was talking about her business. And she later became a client, and she's done just about every single coaching program I've done. Not all of them, but quite a few. So someone might say that was frivolous to spend that much money on a dress. And yet that dress had a follow-on effect of multiple tens of thousands of dollars. See how that works? Your belief structure about what you think money should be used for may be holding you back. So, to repeat, money is a key resource. It is used to exchange value. And you decide what you see as valuable. This is so key whether you're in business for yourself or work for someone else. You must understand the role money plays. It's an exchange of value. It's a mechanism. It's a tool. Okay? And you want more of it because you want to buy more things of value. You want to create a larger life for yourself that's more valuable, that you've always desired and yet don't understand how to create. Now, there are many things that you already spend money on, that you already value, things like the groceries or the mortgage. And sometimes you buy things of a higher value as well that stretch you. And sometimes you want things of a higher value that stretch you, but you haven't yet made the buying purchase. Like, maybe it's buying those nicer clothes that I was talking about, or decorating your home with nicer furniture. That was a big one for me. Or even buying a nicer home in a better location. Maybe you want to move to the beach. So many people who want to move to Florida in my life. I've helped so many clients make those kinds of big moves. In fact, I was just talking to a client who wants to move to Florida and have a place with a lanai. Like, it's very clear. This is a value issue. Every client that I've helped move to the beach in Florida, okay, and I've helped at least three, they had to value themselves, value their lives at a higher level in order to call in the money required to make that move. It's kind of a chicken and an egg thing. You must perceive your value higher and therefore change your business model to meet that value level and then do the work at that next value level in order to call in more money. But the first thing you have to make a decision. You have to decide, yeah, I'm worth it. I am going to Florida in this case. Okay. So it could be anything. It could be maybe sending your kids to college, flying first class, or staying at nicer hotels when you travel. That's a big one for people. I know there hasn't been a lot of travel recently with COVID, but for instance, I really support my clients raising their worthiness level, raising their value level by staying in nicer hotels, by like treating themselves to a nicer environment. You know, we do the Spirit of Wealth Mastermind and Masterclass, and part of it is a January retreat. And under normal circumstances, that's in person at a 5-star hotel. And last year we did it at the Four Seasons in Santa Fe. This year, for those people who are traveling, we're doing it at the Ritz-Carlton at Dove Mountain in Arizona. And some people are dialing in via live stream, but some people are flying. And last year, after the experience, one of my clients in the program said to me that it was such a life-altering experience to have given herself, as a result of joining the program, this experience at this retreat, to take that time away for herself and be in a beautiful environment, that she then booked quarterly retreats for herself. And that's the way it works. She saw herself at a higher level, valued herself at a higher level by stepping into the program, experienced that higher level of value, and then took the next step. It's an upward spiral. She then took the next step, and those retreats then allowed her to do the business planning that she needed to do to really grow her business. And she's someone who has done exceedingly well. She has more than replaced her salary that she was receiving at Google, and has crossed the 6-figure mark, and did that very early in the year, not just at the end of the year. So it's a cumulative thing, but you need to start investing in your value and your worth in order to call in more. There's a correlation there that is hard for people to see initially, but as you get good at this, you'll start tracking this. Okay, so there is something that you value that you want, and if you want it, if the desire is felt, that is part of your growth path, meaning that it's part of what is going to lead you to your purpose, to a fuller expression of who you are, to living out your potential, and quite frankly, stepping into your divine self. We are both human and spiritual beings, so human beings and spiritual beings. We work in that duality, and our job here on earth is to appreciate our humanness and let spirit work through us to expand and create more. It needs that life force energy, needs the human form to create more. It is through us that this life force creates. And our job is to do that and expand and continue to grow into more. And as we do that as human beings, what ends up happening is that we become closer and closer to our spiritual selves, our divine selves, We merge, we become one, and it's quite amazing and beautiful. So this is your more life directive, okay? This is the purpose of life is growth and expansion. Life force wants to grow through you, and it can only do that if you continue to grow. And part of the way you must continue to grow is through expanding your desires and acting on them. Spirit, source, the universe, God lets you know what your next step is in terms of stepping into your purpose and in terms of stepping into your growth, your divine self, through your desires. That's how you know which way to grow. Now, sometimes you step into your desire and you make a purchase. Say you buy a car and you thought it was the car that you really, really wanted. You thought it was going to be perfect and had all the bells and whistles that you wanted. But sometimes that doesn't turn out to be the accurate result. It turns out that the car isn't all that. And you then say, oh no, I made a mistake. Now you have two options here. You either can step into recrimination and beat yourself up, tell yourself that you shouldn't have made that buying decision, that you shouldn't have bought that car, that you can't trust yourself, that you need to scale back all your other purchases, that you're untrustworthy basically with money. Or you could say, wow, what did I learn from this experience? Oh, I learned that I needed to do more due diligence with understanding what bells and whistles I actually do want in a car. I need more clarity before I buy something. I need to recognize that I really like leather seats and not fabric seats, that I really do care about a sound system. But you wouldn't have known those things until you had the experience. So is the mistake really a mistake in terms of a failure, as in terms of something that should cause you to retreat? No. That mistake is something that you learn from. And then if you continue to stay in growth and you have a growth mindset, you learn from it and you take additional action. You don't stop. You take additional action. That might be turning in the car and getting a new one. That might be appreciating the car. Maybe the lesson is like, learn to appreciate exactly what you have. Or maybe after 6 months of loving the car, like nothing's wrong with it, you have a desire for a different car. That's fine. Maybe it's just a sign that you like variety. Own that. It doesn't have to make you wrong. Okay? Now, But many people make buying decisions. The result doesn't turn out the way they want it to. And then they use it as a way to play at the same level. They use it as a way to stop. They use it as a way to make themselves wrong. Don't do that. Don't do that. The more mistakes you make with a growth mindset, so you're assessing them, you're learning from them, the closer to the truth of who you are, you will move closer to the truth of who you are. So drop the recrimination with the mistakes. It doesn't work. It doesn't work for growth. But most people never test this out because they don't understand money and they are a slave to it. They think that if they make a buying decision that doesn't work, that all is lost. And by the way, it doesn't work, doesn't give them the results that they want. All is lost. But that's not true. That's a false understanding of how the universe works. This is the exact experience you needed to grow. And if you stay in the growth and you continue moving forward, you will be mastering money rather than staying a slave to it. So, being a slave to money, what do I mean by that? I mean that you don't know how to create it and you fear it running out. So you let it deter your behavior rather than being in charge, rather than you making a decision, a buying decision, whether it's for your business or for your life, based on abundance, based on knowing how money works, based on understanding the laws of the universe, and particularly based on understanding the role of value. We're going to get into that in a lot more detail momentarily. Most people are so afraid of making a mistake with their money because they don't know how to create it. They have absolutely no clue how to create it. They don't know the process to demanding more of it, insisting on more of it. They think it's going to run out, that there's not enough of it, that it's a limited resource. Yet there is more money in circulation now than ever before. Think about that. There is more money now in circulation than ever before, and it continues to expand. It continues to expand. There's not a limitation of money. It's not a limited resource. It continues to expand. You just have a cash flow issue. It's just not in your bank account. It's not flowing to you. And you don't know how to create that cash flow. And it's super important to know this. So of course you need a great business plan. Of course you need something fabulous to sell. If you're in a corporation or a company and you work for someone else, of course you are selling yourself there. But you can do that as a master, not a slave. It works in all arenas. So how do you actually create more flow? How do you do that? Well, you have to increase your value. And the law of compensation says that you will be compensated according to the need for what you do, your ability to do it, and the difficulty in replacing you. The latter point, this third point, is so critical. The difficulty in replacing you. You must become bigger than your present place. You must grow into more. You must become a fuller expression of who you are in order to be difficult to replace. And you must increase your value. You must become more valuable. If you understand this, buying decisions become so much easier and you are no longer a slave to money. But money works for you. It's a tool for you. You actually start behaving in a way where you're seeing it as a resource that you control rather than something that is going to run out. Let me give you an example. This is from my own business, and it's a very recent example. It just happened a couple days ago. We are looking at hiring a copywriter. We have lots of copy that we write in our company, from social media posts to newsletters to web pages. Lots and lots and lots and lots and lots of copy from, you know, the programs that we create, all the communications, all of that. And it's very important to the lifeblood of a business that it is an accurate representation of the business, that it communicates what we're doing well, and that it's effective, that it's speaking to our audience, helping them understand what we do, and encouraging them to take the next step with us. It's a critical piece in every single business. Our business is very heavy on the copy side. And at the moment, I review, I would say, 80% of the copy that goes out. It's quite a bit. Not all the copy. Maybe it's actually 70%, but it's a good amount. And I am becoming a bottleneck to the growth of our company. It's not a good use of my time. I'm getting a little frustrated, and I am stopping the flow, the speed with which we can grow. And I first approached solving this issue from the classic business approach. Can we afford hiring a copywriter? Is it in the budget? Those are legitimate questions to ask, without a doubt. You must be looking at those sorts of things. And we've been hiring a ton this year. We've increased our headcount in our company this year alone by 80%. That's significant. Can we keep going at this rate? Or is this the straw that's going to break the camel's back? These are the kinds of questions that I was asking myself. And I was even having conversations with my two top leads in my company about this very question. And yet something wasn't landing right. I wasn't approaching it from the right perspective. I wasn't evaluating it in the correct way, even as I talked it out with my top two leads in the company. Okay. And I valued their opinions, and it was a fruitful conversation. And yet I know that I did not leave either of those conversations with clarity. And when there's confusion, there's a lie. I understand that principle. When there's confusion, there's a lie. That meaning there is some untruth in how I am perceiving this situation. I'm not seeing it from the perspective of spirit, source, universe, truth. I'm not seeing it from this perspective. I'm not recognizing the truth in the situation. I'm in some sort of limited perspective on it. So what did I do? I recognized that, and I realized, okay, I'm usually a quick decider. I usually get to clarity very quickly. Why was I pausing here? Why wasn't I clear? And then it came to me. I wasn't working according to law. I wasn't deciding based on law. I was being a slave to money rather than a master of it. Do you see that? I was like, can we afford it? That is a fear-based perspective. Instead, I needed to be a master of it and say, is this something that is going to add value to the company? And moreover, this was a self-worth issue or a value situation. I was not allowing myself to become more, me personally, not just the company. I was hindering my own growth by not valuing myself and my time appropriately, saying that it was acceptable for me to still do this intensive review of the copy that was taking up a good portion of my time. It was and actually diminishing my value. And here's the tricky part about all of this. You must be willing to do the work. You can't be too good for it. So what do I mean by that? I have not been too good to do the copy. I will get my hands dirty. The buck stops with me. I'm the owner of the company. If the copy's not at a great level that's representative of what I want, I own that. I need to be willing to do the work and not say that I'm too good for it, okay? And you must learn to love the work of growing your business, all the aspects of it. You must love the journey. And it's not just saying, I don't like doing that, and opting out. And people do this all the time, especially with sales, especially with accounting or numbers stuff. They're like, I'm not good with math. I don't want to do that. You have to look at the numbers, okay? The numbers don't lie. Or system processes. People get really hooked with that. So sales, accounting, system processes. If you just say, I don't like it, I'll avoid it, that doesn't work, you guys. You gotta love the journey and be willing to do that work. And yet the flip side of that is to know when it's time to let go of that work, okay? There comes a time where it's no longer your job. Your value has increased. You have become more. And in this case, I must value myself more and see myself as worthy of having this additional help. So the buying decision then becomes easy. Yes, to the additional hire. I am worthy of it. But here's the rub. It can't be entitlement. You can't just say, oh, yes, I'm worthy of that, and not do the work. We are going to have to do the work to increase the cash flow so that it supports all the hires that we are making. No question about that. But I need to make that decision on faith, if you will, that it will be something that will scale the business, that it will call in more money. And that is exactly how I have grown my business up until now. Why stop now? it does demand that you look at your numbers. It does demand that you understand what your budget is. It does set a new standard. It says, okay, now we have to make this money to have this kind of profitability, given that we're hiring these people. What does that look like? You must do the work, but there's always uncertainty there, okay? We don't know 100% that we're gonna meet all our targets. There's always uncertainty there. Now, I know how to meet targets. I know the process, so that's not terrifying for me. And in the beginning, you know, I started at a much smaller scale and I learned how to do this incrementally, but quickly. I call that running the stairs. You don't want to do it slowly. You want to do it quickly and you want to do it incrementally. And the increments in the beginning are smaller, but you must stretch yourself and make those increments bigger and bigger as you go. Okay. Now this brings us back to making mistakes. You might make a mistake. This might be a mistake that I'm making. I doubt it, but this might be a mistake that I'm making. But if you have an inaccurate belief that says your worthiness, your safety, your security comes from being right, from never being wrong, you're 100% trapped. And it's a chicken and egg kind of thing. If you need to know in advance that you're not going to make a mistake, but you can't know in advance if you're not going to make a mistake until you do it, how the heck are you going to grow? That's a trap. And if you're afraid of making mistakes, you will never grow. And that's a trap. And you wonder why you're frustrated with the playing small or the not getting ahead, not having that cash flow, not being worried about paying payroll, okay? Not worrying about paying something is freedom. But you have to get there, and you have to get there by taking a different kind of action, which requires that you take you make different kinds of decisions. So there's a moment where you must put a line in the sand and say, I am valuable, and do the thing that proves it. You spend the money, okay? You make that buying decision. And you remember, money is an exchange of value. So I'm giving money, I'm giving a salary for this position in exchange for the value of that work. The value I'm getting is not just killer copy, by the way. Nope, not just that. Not just taking that off my plate even and freeing up my time, though that's extraordinarily valuable to me. But in valuing myself at a higher level, my exchange value out there in the world becomes higher and more money flows to me, i.e. cash flow. Okay, but of course, it's flowing out too. You can't be afraid to spend it. My value is increasing in this world. My exchange value is increasing in this world. So it's going to flow to me in higher quantities. The flow is going to increase. Now, the flow has to be flow, though. It has to go out as well. You cannot be afraid to spend the money. Money is supposed to be in circulation. You must perceive yourself as more valuable, but again, not in an entitled way, okay? You have to actually show up and grow and become more, become bigger than your present place. And you do that by growing yourself. You don't do that by staying in fear of making a mistake. You have to grow yourself, which requires putting yourself out there. And your perception of yourself is key. You must perceive yourself as more valuable. You must see yourself that way. This is self-image. Okay, so you have to change your self-image. So, so key. How you see yourself is your self-image. And you must continue to raise the standard on this. How you see yourself, how much value you perceive your worth. And this is one of the things that we really work on in the Spirit of Wealth Mastermind and Masterclass. We really help you see yourself differently, see yourself at a higher level, value yourself more. So if you're interested in learning the process for that, book a consult with me. I would absolutely love to talk to you. You can go to theunstoppablewoman.com/next level. Okay, so then you have to ask yourself, how quickly can you do this? Can you close the gap on time? in terms of continuing to look at things from a value perspective. Okay? My confusion, my being in the story, the lie, if you will, lasted 2 days. I had my first conversation on Friday, and it is now Sunday morning, okay, that I'm recording this. So that's longer than normal for me, but it's still pretty quick relative to most people. I'm constantly challenging myself to close the gap on time on all these kinds of decisions and recognizing what the lie is in the decision-making process. So you want to do this for yourself at whatever level you're at. So you want to take bigger leaps and you want to take steady leaps. Okay. And this is one of the keys to scaling your business. Okay. You cannot be afraid to own your value. You cannot be afraid to make decisions. You cannot be afraid to make mistakes. Not only will your business and your profits grow slowly if you are in that kind of fear, but you will always feel trapped by money, no matter how much of it you make. Because you're basing your money decisions on an inaccurate belief structure. And this creates a lack of freedom in your life because you will always be a slave to money instead of a master of it. If you start learning these kinds of principles and applying them regularly, quickly, closing the gap on time, you will recognize that you have absolute control over the spigot, over the money flow, over the cash flow, regardless of what industry you're in, regardless of where you're at in your business, regardless of whether you work for yourself, run your own business, run an empire, or work for someone else. Maybe you're a second in command. Maybe you're a high-level manager. Maybe you're a C-suite person. Maybe you're a middle manager. Maybe you're just getting started working. So if you never want to be a slave to money again, if you want true freedom, which means you know how to create money, you know the methodology, you know the steps, you know the principles, and you're working and living according to those principles, then you have to ask yourself, are you open-minded enough to really step into living this way? Most of the world doesn't live this way, and they're trapped, they're limited, they don't get ahead, they never know how to create money for themselves. So if you're open-minded about this, if you're willing to go, wait a second, what she's saying makes sense, and how I'm doing it over here makes me anxious about money, makes me nervous about money, then maybe there's a better way. And maybe it's time to get help with that. Nudge, nudge, hint, hint. So the Spirit of Wealth is enrolling now for 2021. Make this the year that you break through. Make this the year that you quantum leap. Make this the year that you master this material. Reach out, book that consult, and let's find out if this is the right program for you, and we'll take it from there. Okay, rock it out, be unstoppable, have an amazing day, and value yourself. Hey there, my friend. Do you resonate with what you just heard? Then head over to our free resource page and get more of our good stuff, including our free Unstoppable Woman Playbook and Money Breakthrough System. You'll find that and more at theunstoppablewoman.com/freestuff. Thank you so much for listening. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next episode.